Many people think that programming is just writing code, but let's face it, a programmer spends most of the time reading, thinking, or browsing the internet rather than writing code. And in fact, knowing how to search information is one of the most crucial skills for any programmer. Okay, so what should you do when you need information? And there are several base cases. Either you need information because your code doesn't work, or because you have a broader question about implementation design or how to implement an algorithm in a Julian way, for example. The former case is more simple and straightforward, but you can still use the same method for broader questions. The difference is that you probably won't find right away the answer that fits your needs about specific implementations. But the nice thing is that the Julia community is very often here for you. So let's find out how to get help when programming in Julia. If your code doesn't work, it's most probably because you misused the function, but it can also come from a bug in said function. If you have an error, the first thing to do, of course, is try and fix it by yourself. So let's take an array, for example, called A with values 2, 1, 5. And let's say I want to find what is the minimum value in A. So I could try and use the min function to do that. But if I execute it, I find out that Julia returns me an error. So the first thing to do is to read that error. So here it tells me that there is a method error, no method matching what I requested, the minimum of an array of int 64. And it tries to help me by giving me the closest methods that I can use, but it doesn't help me very much here. So the next step is to investigate in the documentation of the min function. To do so, we just have to type the question mark to enter the documentation mode, and then to type the name of your function. So here it's min, and press enter. So here we have the documentation for the min function, and it says that it returns the minimum of its arguments, and that there is another function called minimum that returns the minimum element from a collection. So we should use the minimum function instead of the min function for A, because A is a collection of values. It's an array like this. What we can do also is to explore the code behind the function to better understand how it works. So now I switch to Visual Studio Code, and I can use the @edit macro to see the code behind the function call. So for example, if I want to investigate which code is called when I type min of 1 and 2, for example, I can use the @edit macro just before my function call. And if I execute this line by pressing Ctrl and Enter, it will open the script where there is the particular implementation of this min function call. So it opened the promotion.jl file, which is in the base package of Julia, at this particular line here, which is the implementation of the min function with two arguments that have the same type, which is a subtype of real. So if you don't know what are types or structures, don't worry, we will make some videos about that. The important thing to see here is that this is the implementation of the min function with two arguments. And so here we test whether the y argument is lower than the x argument. And if it is, it returns the y value. If it's not, it returns the x value. And after all these steps, if you still don't understand what is happening in your code, if you have an error, for example, well, just Google it. And a good way to search for an error on the web is to copy-paste the part of the error that is generic. So back to our previous example with min of A that didn't work previously. There are different parts inside an error message that are more or less generic. So the most generic part is this one, method error, no method matching, etc. This would apply to any function call that is not implemented. And then you have the name of the function and after the particular call you made. So depending on your use case, you can either copy paste the whole message here on a search engine. Or if you use a very particular corner case of a function, well, just take the most generic part, either this or with the function name. To search for Julia error on the web, the trick is to prefix the search with the JuliaLang keyword and then to paste the error and press enter. So here we have answers in Stack Overflow, Discourse, and also GitHub. And they are the three main websites where you can find answers for your questions about Julia programming. Stack Overflow is very well indexed on the search engines, and it's a Q&A, so you can ask a question and people will answer here below your question, and the best answer with the most upvotes will always be up. So it's very easy to find the answer when you're searching on Stack Overflow. The Julia discourse is very active and people are really nice there. So you can also ask a question here and people will answer just below. And if you're using a particular package, well, you can find issues from the GitHub repository of that package. So for example, here, it's a past issue that is actually closed, but we can find answers in these issues in the past. And you can also search in the issues database here. So for example, if you search method error here, you'll have to use keywords here. You can press enter and you have all the issues opened with method error somewhere in the issue. And here it's the opened issues. But if you want closed issues, you can just remove this and press enter and you'll have all the issues here. And sometimes it's really handy. And if you still can't find an answer, you can ask a question on Discourse, Stack Overflow, or open an issue depending on the context. Generally, GitHub issues are more used for bug or ideas that you want to bring to the developers of a given package. So if you have a more generic question, it's better to ask it on Stack Overflow or Discourse. You can also ask questions on Zulip or Slack, but I prefer posting on Stack Overflow or Discourse because the answers help the whole community and they don't disappear. Either way, there is a method to follow when you ask questions on these websites. First, you'll have to state very clearly what you need and what you've tried before. So here is, for example, a question I asked several months ago about data frame auto-completion when working with Julia in VS Code. So in my question, I state what I was expecting from the VS Code extension and I didn't get. And I was wondering if it was a bug or just a feature that is not yet implemented. And I tried my best to be short enough, but give all the information that is needed to reproduce my error. So this is very important. It's called reproducible examples, and it's really important so other people can find the same issues as you have. And sometimes it's also interesting to put the version of the package and also the version and the name of your operating system if needed. The basic thing that you have to remember here is that you have to put effort on your question to help others help you. Also, you have to keep your title very specific. Don't simply put, I have a problem with package XX, but rather, well, function XX from package Y returns Z and I expected W, for example. And this is really more specific and it helps others help you. And if you ask a question on multiple places also, well, make sure to put the links of all the places you ask the questions onto the questions themselves so people can find the answer if someone answered that question on a specific website, and it will avoid efforts from others if it is already answered somewhere. You can also find more general information on YouTube, for example. There are more and more content creators like me that make videos about Julia nowadays, and there's potentially some video that can help you. Don't forget about the main manual of Julia also, because, well, most of your questions will be answered just by reading this manual. It's very well done. You also have juliaacademy.com that provides several courses about Julia, how to use Julia, etc. And there's also this page, julialong.org/learning, that tracks everything about how to learn about Julia, like the exorcism Julia track, the manual, Julia Academy, but also YouTube channels, tutorials, books, etc. And if you're wondering which package you should use for your particular use case, you can go to juliapackages.com. It's a website that tracks every Julia package, and you can filter by categories such as biology, for example, and by subcategories here. So biomedicine, for example, there's two packages. You have a similar website called juliaobserver.com that tracks also all the packages. And the nice thing of these two websites is that you can go to the package and see many more information such as contributors, available versions, etc. Here you have this, and you can also access the website if there is one of the package page by clicking here, or access the code by clicking here on GitHub. So the website is here and the GitHub code is here. This video is part of a playlist, so if you're interested in Julia programming, make sure to watch those videos from that playlist to watch them in order. Thank you for watching, and I see you next time.